Hey, what's up, everyone? This is Ishwar, and this is my project update for the last year from March 2020 to now March 2021 in beautiful Morongo Valley, California, where the weather is always nice. I love Morongo Valley. Morongo Valley is centrally located in the Coachella Valley. We're about 25 minutes away from Palm Springs International Airport, where you can hop on an airplane and be anywhere in the United States if you like to travel. It's very convenient. Morongo Valley also has its own nature reserve, and I happen to live very, very close by this nature preserve. If you're a nature lover and you love nature, this is the place to be. Birds from all over the world come here to migrate seasonally. We have all the wildlife and all the animals that you can possibly think about. You know, so for a nature lover, Morongo Valley is very orgasmic. I came to Morongo Valley about 4 years ago. You know, Morongo Valley is a very beautiful place, and I love it very much. But, you know, this is the starting point to my life. The end point to my life is the ocean. I'm an ocean boy. It's where I belong. It's where my soul is. Well, you know, I'm a pretty smart guy. I guess I can have the best of both worlds. I can have the desert and I can have the ocean. Morongo Valley is the desert. Crescent City is the ocean. All I have to do is manage my time, manage the seasons, and I would be able to have the best of both worlds. So I just want to take a quick second and do a recap. I came to Morongo Valley 4 years ago. One reason I came was because I broke my own heart and I came out here to do some soul searching. In Morongo, the Native Americans once settled here. So this is a very special and spiritual place. So while I'm here, I wanted to break myself free from the banks, from the insurance company, from the car companies, from California traffic, from all the long lines in the grocery stores, from the utility company, and most importantly, from all of the bad people in the world. You know, I wanted to be more independent, I wanted to be more self-sufficient, and I wanted to be more self-reliant. I'm a very independent person. I wanted to escape the rat race and the hustle and bustle of things. I truly believe that life is what you make of it. There will be no genie in a bottle that will magically appear and tell you the meaning of life. Life is what you make of it. You get what you put into it, and I firmly believe that. You know, there are 24 hours in a day for everyone, globally. For myself, my self-worth has been how well I utilize those 24 hours to my advantage. You know, I work my butt off. I don't have a movie star talent. I don't have a rock star talent, and I don't have an athletic talent. So what I do instead is that I try my best to outwork everyone. I work 12 to 14 hours a day, 6 days out of the week, so I can stay ahead of everybody else that only puts in 8 hours or 10 hours, just 5 days out of the week. So what I do is that I work my butt off within those 24 hours so I can stay ahead of everyone that's around me. As the video plays in the background, you can see that my words and my action comes to life. I talk the talk and I walk the walk. For 4 years now, I've been working on my ranch little by little. There's never enough hours in the day for me, nor is there never enough daylight in the day for me. I'm now 41 years old. I'm middle-aged. The statistics are that average person live to be 78 years old, which means that I have about 37 years left to live. I hope to live forever. I hope to live as long as possible, but that's not the way it works, right? But one thing's for sure for me and one thing's for certain, the clock is on and it's ticking. You know, I love listening to music. I love music very much. Music stimulates my mind. It enhances my imagination. It completes my thought. It just inspires me. So I love listening to music when I work, and I love following along in my head and forming my thoughts.
It's been a long road getting from there to here. It's been a long time, but my time is finally near. And I can feel a change in the wind right now. Nothing's my way, and they're not gonna hold me down no more. No, they're not gonna hold me down. Cause I've got faith of the heart.
So at my age, you know, fitness plays a very important role to me. You know, I like to stay fit. I like the burn that my body feels every morning. I like the soreness when I wake up in the morning. I yearn for that feeling. But one thing, you know, when you're in your 40s, your testosterone level drops, right? So it's hard for you to find energy. With me, it's different. You know, I'm so self-motivated. And I'm so dedicated to what I want to do. You know, I'm like a one-man army.
I don't need anyone to try to motivate me. I know what I need to do, and I go ahead and I get it done. You know, I don't like working out in a gym. I find it boring, and I think it's a waste of time and a waste of energy. I believe in working on my land. This way my body, my mind, and my soul, they're working together productively and in harmony to improve themselves, and also at the same time to carve and reshape the earth to leave it in a better place than the way I found it. You know, I left to work out on my property. I remember when I used to live in the city, I used to hate it having to get up and get ready, get in the car, and then drive to the gym. That lag time right there was a downer in energy, especially if you had worked all day or you're trying to work out before you go to work. That energy you have to find to motivate yourself, and that lag time sucks. But for me, it's a different situation here. You know, I love working out on my property, and these are just a few examples of how I work my body out and how beneficial the energy that I put into what I'm doing, you know, works out in my favor. You know, I carry 50-pound bag of cement. You know, I plant my fruit trees, I plant my flower trees, I plant my palm trees, and all of these are in 15-gallon containers. All of these things are heavy. I dig holes, I shovel, I cut trees down, I move logs. So what I do, I work out every single part of my body, and I enjoy that. So for me, there's no lag or downtime. I can just go straight to work, and I can enjoy what I'm doing. But also at the same time, the energy that I use go into productivity as far as planting some beautiful flowers or getting some fruits for some trees down the line and rebuilding my fence or making an enclosure for my pets or building concrete mushrooms for decoration or building stepping stones. So my energy goes into my body. It goes into my hobbies. And it goes on improving my land and the lifestyle for my pets. So that's why I like to utilize my energy working on my property and not inside of a boring gym, right? I love managing my time. I love managing my time very much. I'm the type of person I can make hard easy. I'm the type of person, if it takes someone 8 hours to do something, I can assure you, I can get it done in 5 hours. You know, I'm very hardworking. I always ask to do the hardest task possible. That's how I show my value. Because again, I'm the type of person that can make hard very easy, right? I always inspire, I always motivate, and I always make the people that are around me better.
how we feel inside. Instead of going down an endless road, not knowing if we did or lied. Something's so worth fighting for. Some feelings never die. I'm not asking for another chance. I just wanna know why. There's no easy way out. There's no shortcut home. There's no easy way out. Giving in can't be wrong.
You know, I like to live by myself. I'm an independent thinker. I'm the type of person I like to live inside of my head. You know, I think too much, I talk too much, and I know too much. In the last 4 years, you know, I did a lot of self-discovery about myself. You know, I had to get over a lot of fears. You know, if I have a snake in my hand, it's because I was rescuing that snake. And I have a fear of snakes. So for me to overcome a fear, that's just one fear that I overcame. You know, that's a pretty amazing self-accomplishment for me. I love the nature that are around me. A baby hawk fell down from the tree. I nursed it back to health and let it be on its way. You know, I love my emus. I'm the only one in this entire small town in Morongo Valley that can say I have a pair of emu. How cool is that? You know, I spent 4 years to reinvent myself. I'm a very happy person now. You know, I've made so many mistakes when I was in my 20s that it set me back a great deal in life. But now, you know, my happiness transcends. You can see my happiness in my dog. You can see my happiness in my emus. You can see my happiness in my land. You know, my mind has come to life. You know, from my thoughts, through my eyes, from my ears, through my mouth, with my hands and my feet. You know, my actions come to life. This is my mind. This is my mind alive. You know, it's just live in person instead of being thoughts in your head. So, you know, I just love the person that I'm becoming because it transcends, my happiness transcends from myself to my pets to my land. And I believe it's a complete cycle for me. You know, if you look at things, you could want to call a nickname for me, a playful nickname. I could be Mowgli of the desert.
So far and wide, keep Manhattan, just give me that countryside.
New York is where I'd rather stay. I get allergic smelling hay. I just adore a penthouse view. Darling, I love you, but give me Park Avenue.
The chores.
The stores.
Fresh air. You are my wife.
Goodbye, city life.
Green Acres, we are there.
Come and knock on our door.
Come and knock on our door.
We've been waiting for you.
We've been waiting for you.
Where the kisses are hers and hers and his. Three's company too. Come and dance on our floor.
Come and dance on our floor.
Take a step that is new.
Take a step that is new.
We've a lovable space that needs your face. Three's company too. You'll see that life is a ball again. Laughter is calling for you. Down at our rendezvous.
Down at our rendezvous.
Three's company too.
Three's Company was videotaped in front of a studio audience.
You know, I'm very proud of all the hard work that I've put in the last 4 years. You know, for me, it means a great deal. Maybe to other people that are watching, it doesn't mean anything. But for me, it means a great deal because, you know, I worked myself out of poverty. You know, for a guy who didn't have a mother or a father, everything that I did was a mistake. You know, every time I took one step forward, I went three steps back, you know, because I didn't have that guidance there of a caring family. So I had to do everything and learn from my mistake, right, through trial and error. So for me, you know, what I have achieved means a great deal. It takes a lot of hard work. It takes a lot of dedication. And it takes a lot of sacrifice to work yourself out of poverty. You know, I used to live in San Bernardino, California, and I love San Bernardino. San Bernardino prepared me mentally for where I am at today in my life. You know, but San Bernardino's, this area I lived in, is bad. And to work yourself out of that type of area and that type of lifestyle, you know, it took a lot of sacrifice. I wasted a lot of my weekends just staying at home, trying to work my way out of a hole. You know, it took me years and years. You know, people gave up hope on me. People quit on me. But I never stopped believing in my goals. I never stopped believing in my ambitions. You know, the more people abandoned me, the more people had less faith on me, less faith with me, you know, it drove me. My mind was in a different place. You know, because I had to achieve what was inside of my head. But it took a great deal of sacrifice of my time to work myself out of poverty and work myself out of the hole that I was in at that time. You know, my road hasn't been an easy one. It's always been difficult for me. Ever since I was a kid, I've always been one of the smartest one in the room. Even up to date currently, I'm still one of the smartest one in the room. And to most people that might be easy, but that's a difficult thing because it takes me a while to come out of my shell. And it's a difficult thing when in modern time, currently, the vast majority of people that are around you are not very educated. You know, they don't have too much common sense. It's like currently common sense isn't too common anymore. So it makes it a difficult thing. I'm happy with my life. I'm very happy with the way I'm living it. I want to be a good person. I want to live every day to its fullest. And I want to make the people that are around me very happy. I don't want to ever be an angry person. I don't ever want to be an upset person. I don't ever want to be a disgruntled person. All I want is happiness. All I want is for my thought to be joyous. You know, it's like that song. I have a pocket full of sunshine, and I just want to share it everywhere. 4 years ago, I gave up vanity. I gave up buying expensive shoes. I gave up buying expensive jeans. I gave up buying expensive sport coats. I give up on buying expensive shirts. I give up buying expensive sunglasses. You know, materialistic things do not mean anything to me anymore. I don't believe in making someone else wealthy. I believe in myself. What matters to me now is character, personality, integrity, loyalty, and trust. Brand and materialistic things are not even in my list anymore. Everything that you see that I have that's a brand or something close to looking expensive is because it was a gift from a family or a friend. But as far as myself, I've given up vanity. Materialistic things just doesn't mean anything to me. It doesn't matter what a person owns. It doesn't matter what they have. You know, at the end of the day, when you pass on, you can't take it with you. So while you're here, what matters is a person's character, in my opinion. You know, my opinion, as people live their life, one of the key things people should learn is not to care what other people think about yourself. I mean, it's so important for you not to care about what other people think. You know, maintain your confidence and stay true to yourself. You know, do not lower your standards for anyone. Believe in yourself, because it's true what they say. You know, if you believe in yourself, you can achieve anything you put your mind to, as long as you're willing to put in the time and the hard work, you can achieve it. As you can see in my videos, I love myself. I could care less what other people think about me. All I know is that I've always loved myself. I've always loved my hair. And there's never a brush that's too far away from me. So, you know, believe in yourself and love yourself. And always put yourself first. It's important to put yourself first, but it's also important to remember not to be selfish, right? But to put yourself first means, you know, you have to make sure that you're healthy. You have to make sure that you're taken care of first. Because if you're not healthy and you're not taken care of, then you can't help anyone else, right? So that's what I mean when I say love yourself and put yourself first. Because, you know, without your health and your well-being, you're going to be unable to help others. So it's important to love yourself in that aspect. Thank you. I keep myself busy every day. You know, every day I find myself chasing the sun. You know, it doesn't matter what I'm doing, research, or I'm just trying to find a new project to get into, or I'm trying to find a new hobby. I always fill my day up to its fullest when it comes to my property, because I just love every aspect of everything that I'm doing. And I do everything myself. I maintain my fence myself. I trim my trees myself. I do all of my own raking. You know, I paint my own house. I fix my own window. I fix my own well shack. I fix my own water well. You know, I fix my own car. I make my areas for my pets to be secure, their enclosures. You know, every aspect of things that you can possibly think of for a person to be self-sufficient and be independent and rely on themselves, I try my best to do. Because in this modern day and time, you know, everyone thinks you need help, or everyone thinks that you can't make it if you don't have a boyfriend or a girlfriend, that you need that. You need to be married in order for you to get things done. You know, for me, I want to prove to myself that I can find happiness and content within myself first. You know, it's important for me to challenge myself in modern time to see if I can make it on my own. You know, for my self-worth, you know, I would not be a fulfilled person if I didn't know how to cook for myself, or if I didn't know how to take care of myself as far as finance-wise or employment-wise, you know. Or what's different from me is that I'm a city boy, you know, I'm a manager. I'm not really a handy guy. I'm not a home fixer-upper type of guy. I have to learn all these things. Where if a normal person who has parents or whose family member taught them construction, or at least that it'll be easy for them. But for me, I spend tons and tons of hours researching. Then I go and I apply. I screw up. I apply. I research again. Then I come back and I apply it again. So for me, it's a lot of back and forth. So, you know, it's quite different for me because every day is learning on my own. So that's where I take pride and I get the fulfillment. It's, you know, learning by mistake and learning on your own, not having somebody to help you. It's like you have to rely on yourself to learn how to get it done. You have to be creative and you have to be pretty ingenious. There's a saying, a man's land is his pride. And clearly, you can see my pride. You can clearly see how prideful I am. You can clearly see by all the projects that I learn on my own and I get involved in, and all the hobbies that I have, you can clearly see my mind out in the open. You can clearly see. When I do my videos, I like my videos to be raw. You know, I know my grammar is a little bit off and the editing is a little bit off. And I don't have a whole lot of memory in my computer and the app sometimes sticks. But for me, what's important is that I get my message across to everyone. You know, just to say something about my intellect. You know, in my high school class, I believe there was probably a little bit over 400 graduated students. You know, out of all those 400 students, to my knowledge, I'm the only one that was poor man retire at the age of 33. So that just goes to speak just a little bit towards my intellect, that out of my graduating class, I'm the only one that was poor man retire at the age of 33. You know, I don't think I'm better than anyone. I think everybody is equal. You know, we all shop at the same store. We all put on our pants one leg at a time. You know, I think the only thing that's different from me and the people that are around me is my drive, the way I think, the way I carry myself, and the way I conduct myself. I just have a different way of thinking. That's the only thing that makes me different from people that are around me. But besides that, we're all equal, and I don't believe in races. I believe in one race. I believe in the human race. I came to Morongo Valley 4 years ago to start a new life. And I love my new life. I have excelled in all aspects of my new life. It's great fulfillment for me. Every afternoon when I look up at the sun, I reminisce. I reminisce on how happy I am that I'm no longer stuck in traffic while the sun is going down. I'm no longer stuck in an office, or I'm no longer stuck in a grocery store when the sun is going down. I'm standing right outside. I'm looking at it. And I can't help but to reminisce about all the past civilization. You know, like the Mayan, the Incas, the Egyptians, the Hindu, the Muslims, and so forth. You know, everyone used to look up at the sun with the same thought, the same wonder, the same curiosity. So for me to be able to stand still and just to look up and observe, you know, it's a moment that I appreciate. And while I'm looking up at the sun, you have to think deep. You know, right now, the earth is rotating around the sun. It's wobbling and it's spinning and it's moving 66,000 miles an hour. My dog, her name is Lotus, like the lotus flower. She's a Doberman Pinscher. She's 2 years old. She's very intelligent. She knows well over 20 tricks. I'm very proud of her and she's the love of my life. When I think about Lotus, I think about all of my past dogs that I loved and that I've failed. And I still think about these days. I think about Pooja. I think about Annie. I think about Kit. I think about Tiny. I think about Gigi. I think about Pooja. Well, I said Pooja. I think about Maggie. And I think about my rabbits. You know, I think about Thumper. I think about Lena. I think about Dottie. I also think about my bird, my favorite bird, Chucky. He was a half moon parrot. And he was also a smart bird. You know, and my emus, the name of my emus are Sky, like the sky, and River, like the river, you know, that flows into the ocean. And my emus are the second largest bird in the world, next to the ostrich. The emus are the last remnants of dinosaurs. So for me, as a child growing up with my imagination in Guyana of South America, by the ocean, I always was fascinated by dinosaurs. So for me to be able to own two emus that are a boy and a girl, and that are the last remnants of dinosaur, I find that very amazing. So I love my life. I love my pets. My pets are very happy. They're always around me. They're always playful. You know, and they're my treasures. I love them and I adore them, and they bring me so much happiness and so much joy. It's a privilege for a guy like me who worked himself out of poverty to be able to show what his property looks like in the wintertime when it snows, in the springtime when it's all green and the grass is out, and also in the summertime when everything is all dried up and everything has all died out and once I've cleaned things up. So it's a pleasure for me to be able to show that, because I never thought that I would be able to have something like this, because no one believed in me and everyone quit on me. I had to believe in myself to continue on achieving my goals. So this is why I'm very happy and I'm very proud. Because, you know, I came from nothing and I achieved something with my life to be able to have my independence.
fields I roamed. I gazed and stared. We must have a million fields. I must have died alone, a long, long time ago. Who knows? Not me. I never lost control.
When I look at my pets, when I look at my dog, when I look at my emus, and when I look at my property, and I see the beauty, the happiness, and the fulfillment, that's how I know to myself that I've completed my self-discovery journey, and I know that I'm a pure of heart once again. You know, I remember as a boy, I was pure of heart. I got corrupted. I lost myself in my 20s. I was at fight with myself when I was in my 20s. You know, the battle is not bad people out in the world. The battle is yourself with your mind. You talk to yourself, you talk with your ego, and you talk with your normal self. Your left and your right side communicates. And at the time, I was going through a battle with myself, and I lost. I let my ego dictate everything that I did. And I had to work through it, and in the last 4 years, I believe I overcame it, and I've finally come my full, complete circle, and I'm pure of heart once again, and I can tell by the happiness of my animals, and I can tell by the happiness that's just around me. One of the biggest life lessons that I've learned is how to control your anger. Don't ever give in to anger. The minute you give in to anger, you've lost that fight or that battle that you're going to get yourself involved with. Always maintain your intelligence. Always maintain your intellect. Always maintain your wits about you. Never give in to anger. Always be the intelligent person. Pick your battles. Walk away from fights. Be intelligent. Leave the situation with your freedom and a clean criminal record. Do not spend the night or the month in jail over your ego. In my opinion, bravery is stupidity. Anyone can be brave. Bravery gets you into trouble. Intelligence keeps you out of trouble. It's important to stay your course. No matter what, once you're fixated on your goals and you're set in your mind what you want to accomplish, do not allow any negative situation or any negative people set you back. Stay your course. Do not allow other people to derail you. Lots of people will quit on you. What's important is that you can depend on yourself. I wonder what's gonna go through my mind when I'm an old man and I look back and I watch this video. I wonder if my perspective will change, if I'll have any regrets. But I know as of this moment, I'm very happy, I'm very fulfilled. And I know that I've come to my full circle. You know, when I was younger, I was not a leader. I had to learn how to become a leader. I had to learn how to become my own leader. You know, for me, it's been a difficult journey because I had to learn from all of my mistakes. I still have a lot of work ahead of me. I still have a lot of maintenance to do. I still have a lot of yard art project to do. But I'm very happy that I'm able to share this video with everyone. I want to thank everyone for their time, and thank you very much for watching my videos. my videos. I do not promote my videos. I do not try to make money on my videos. They're just an update or a video diary, something that I can reflect on when I turn old, when an old man in a rocking chair in a hammock, or for my friends, family, coworkers to just look at and just get an idea of what my life is like.
Shut it all with me.
I will have my own kingdom, my own queen.
He sought adventure in distant lands and trod the jeweled thrones of the earth beneath his sandaled feet. Until at last, he found his own kingdom and wore his crown upon a troubled brow.